Hello, welcome to NetVN channel. In this video I will show you how to turn an old laptop into your own peer-to-peer server. Here I have a laptop running Windows 7 64-bit. On the target computer I enable remote desktop so that it can be accessed from another computer. You set up your computer so it never goes to sleep. That way it will always be ready to share files or folders with other computers. This laptop has only 2 GB of internal memory and requires a 64-bit operating system. To control a Windows 7 computer remotely requires a password. If you don't have one, create a new one. This computer doesn't have a password yet, so I created a new one. You set up a strong password to avoid being accessed by bad guys. To remotely access this computer I need to know its IP address, so I open a command prompt and use the ipconfig command to find it. The IP address of this laptop is 192.168.1.8, I will use it in the next step. Setting up the remote desktop for the first time requires a Windows 7 restart for the changes to take effect. Next I use another computer to remotely access the target laptop. Windows 11 computer connected to the same local network as the target computer. In the previous section I learned that the target computer has an IP address of 192.168.1.8, I will use this IP address for remote access. Next I use the password set in the previous step to access the target computer. Successful access to the target computer. I set up a static IP address for the target computer because to build a peer-to-peer server I need to forward the port on the router. Therefore, the target computer needs to have a static IP address to ensure that there are no errors when forwarding ports on the router. Here I set the static IP address for the laptop as 192.168.1.8. I set up the same IP address as before. On a Windows 11 computer I will download the necessary software installers for the target computer and then upload it to the Windows 7 computer. To set up a peer-to-peer server I use qBittorrent. qBittorrent only supports 64-bit operating systems, so I have target computer running Windows 7 64-bit operating system. After downloading the qBittorrent installer I just copied and pasted it to my Windows 7 computer because remote desktop supports that. With a few clicks I have completed the qBittorrent installation. Next you set it up to be a peer-to-peer server. You enable the tracker on qBittorrent, it uses port 9000. This tracker will help connect peer-to-peer computers and help share your data with everyone. Since the laptop is behind the router, I will set up port forwarding to 9000. This is my NetGear router, I will set up port forwarding on it. Perhaps you use a different type of router and a different forwarding method, but make sure you forward port 9000 to the target computer. Here I forward port 9000 to IP address 192.168.1.8. There is another port you need to know, that is the port used to connect to qBittorrent. Here the port to connect to is 33,040.5. You also need to forward this port on your router. Each time qBittorrent is installed on a Windows computer, a different port will be generated. When you install qBittorrent on your Windows computer, you will get another incoming port. So you specify the correct port to forward on the router. On Netgear router I forward port 33,040.5 to IP address 192.168.1.8. So on the router you need to forward two ports, one for monitoring and one for peer-to-peer data sharing. Like here port 9000 for monitoring and port 33,040.5 for peer-to-peer data sharing. You can use the remote desktop to upload to your Windows 7 computer the file or folder you want to share. But that way the download speed will be slow, so on my Windows 7 machine I create a new folder and share it. This way the upload speed of files and folders will be faster. On the C partition of the target computer I create a new folder and share it. You set up sharing on your Windows 7 computer as above. Next I set it up to access the shared folder from my Windows 11 computer without using a password. Now on my Windows 11 computer I access the shared folder using the IP address. I then uploaded a file about 200 MB in size. The file has been uploaded successfully. This upload is faster than when you use remote desktop. On a Windows 7 computer I use qBittorrent to share a file that has just been uploaded. You create the torrent file as above. You add a file you want to share. I set this up as a private torrent. Then set this file to be shared immediately after creating the torrent file. Next you set up the tracker. Here I set up the tracker using the public IP address. Later in the video I will use the free domain to set up the tracker for qBittorrent. To know the public IP address, just open any browser and enter ping.eu. You just need to set up the tracker with the public IP address as above. Then you create a new file, torrent file. Here I create a new folder named torrent to save the generated torrent files. I created new successfully and the tracker is working. On my Windows 11 computer I go to the shared folder to get the torrent file I just created. This is the newly created torrent file. It is very small in size compared to the original file. To download the original file I use any torrent client. On my Windows 11 computer I use the uTorrent client, a popular application. You can use other torrent clients if you want. I just need to use the free version to download files. To check if the original file can be downloaded from the internet, I will connect to another network. The connection is successful. Next, I use ping.eu to check the public IP address. So the public IP address has changed, so the Windows 7 computer and the Windows 11 computer belong to two different networks. After successfully installing the client, I just drag and drop the torrent file to download the original file. Wait a moment for the tracker to work. Once the peer computers have been identified, the original file will be downloaded to the Windows 11 computer. That way I can download the original file over the internet using a peer-to-peer network. The problem we often encounter is that you use a dynamic public IP address, so you cannot use the tracker as above. In the next part of this video, I will use dynamic domain to solve this problem. I use DuckDNS dynamic domain name service to create a new domain name. With DuckDNS, you can create 5 domains for free. This is the domain name I will use for my peer-to-peer server. Next, you download the client software to update the public IP address. This software will automatically update the public IP address every 5 minutes. So you won't need to worry every time the public IP address changes. This client requires a Windows computer with Java installed. If your computer doesn't have Java, install it. My Windows 7 computer doesn't have Java installed, so I need to install it. I have successfully installed Java for the target computer. Now I can use the client to update the public IP address. You set up the domain name and token for the client to map the public IP address to the domain name. The client software has updated the public IP address successfully. So how will I use this domain name on qBittorrent? On qBittorrent, you update the domain name as above. You replace the public IP address with your domain name. Then you create a new torrent file. Next, I will use the torrent file I just created to download the original file. On my Windows 11 computer, I go to the shared folder and get the torrent file I just created. I connect to another network to make sure the two computers are on two different local networks. Each computer has a different public IP address. Just like last time, I drag and drop the torrent file to download the original file. The tracker works fine and I can download the original file through the internet. And this is how I turned an old computer into a peer-to-peer server. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel.